Hey guys, it's Sunday morning. Now, I don't plan to make these videos every day like this. It's just my natural life. You're seeing, this is my life. This is what I do. So today I just like to go in the garage. I'm starting a cleaning, kind of going through my detailing box first. All the stuff I never use. I actually found these, put this down here. So I'm looking through all these pads that have been here for years. I never use them. I think these two are buffing pads to bring out a shine. This one's a little rougher. I don't think I want to use this. I'm thinking about just using this white one here right now on this fresh paint. And one thing also, remember that roughness? It's mostly gone now. It isn't gone, but it's better than it was when I first installed it. And what I just learned about the P21S this morning was that it's a Wow Wow wax, as they call it. And you want to know what that means? That means wipe on, wipe off. What that means is this isn't the type of wax that you need to let dry or set before you pull it off. Man, this lid never fits right. See, it's crooked right there. It's really hard to get the lid on, just FYI. And I think it's just a glitch in this lid. But as soon as you put this on, you can wipe it right off. This isn't the type of wax that needs to harden or set, you know, before you wax it. It doesn't need to dry and get crusty because it's more like an oil. So I didn't know that. I just found that out today. It's, of course, too late now, but that's pretty much what I was doing. Because it's an oil, it comes right off. But just for the hell of it, I want to try one of these buffing pads here. Either that or that on this. And I just reinstalled my handle on purpose. I've always had it off. It's a pain in the butt to use. This is really heavy. And everybody said, don't use the handle. You're going to like put pressure on it wrong and all that crap. Not for me, man. I need the handle. I'm not going to sit there and put it sideways and screw it up. But it's so much more stability with the handle on the Porter cable. I want to use it and it'll make my job easier. I think I have it. Yeah, it's plugged in right now too. Okay. So I want to open this one and compare it to the yellow one. I am looking for a very soft pad and I want to just make sure if they're the same or not. This is brand new. So, I mean, these are the exact same to me. Maybe they're like chemically different, but they feel exactly the same softness to me. So it doesn't matter which one I use in that case. I was just about to take this, just like this, to my paint, and I just have a scary thought. Like, what if this isn't just a shine pad? And what if it's meant to have some kind of liquid or lube on it? And I don't want to just screw up all my paint now without really know what I'm doing. It's soft, but maybe it's not the type of pad that you can just put dry on your paint to bring out the buff. I don't know. And I better hold out, and better to find out first than screw up my paint. Someone can tell me if these two pads can be used dry, if they're just shine, you know, like I've already buffed it out and I just want a nice extra good buff out and I wanted to use this, but I'm just not sure. Then I've had these things forever that I probably will never use. I got a big blue 3. I mean, I'll get rid of them for half price if anybody wants them. And I can't give them free. I'm like pretty broke from all these mods. I'd like to give them all away, but you know, every bit helps. But if anybody does, I can't even find this on this site anymore. But I got a brand new gigantic big blue towel, probably like the ones that I showed you that are ruined. The ones I showed you yesterday. This one's unlabeled, but it's another blue waffle towel. I got some Dragon Fiber Perfect Shine buffing cloth. I might want to keep that. That's Korean made, so that's the top shelf right there. I may want to use that for my own buffing cloth. This yellow one, just another basic cloth. I don't even know what it does. All this takes up room in my bin, really, and I never use it, but I just seem to never want to get rid of it either. Did I ever show you guys those Mishimoto bolts that got stuck the two last times I tried to uninstall it? It was a total nightmare. So I had to take I bought a new Dremel grinder, a really big one. And I drilled slots, ground out an area to punch, and I finally punched these bolts out. It's finally time for me to just get rid of them. Cleaning out my stash. These ones were okay, but they were installed a little bit rounded. These bolts just suck. Throwing them out. Got a bunch of, I think I got 4 or 5 original Subaru studs just in case, but I do got those nice Grimspeed ones on now, and I don't plan to touch those for quite a long time, so they should be fine, I hope. Of course, my original shift bushing, and I have the Delrin Torque Solution bushing in there, and I just saved this one and taped it up for safekeeping. My original oil cap, keep that. This will go, oh, these are for the exhaust flanges on the J-pipes. I'll keep some of those handy. Probably should throw out some of these other ones. I gotta remember what that's for. I can't quite remember. Those are rusty. Why the hell am I gonna keep rusty bolts for years? And, oh yeah, this is a spare, you know, your charge pipe? The top of it. It has this rubber gasket thing. I bought 2 of these once, and I put one on because I ripped up that whole gasket. I forget what I was doing. Something about TGV delete job. So I had a spare one of these. I'll keep this, and you can see that in case you ever need it. The rubber that the charge pipe slots into at the top of your engine. Don't need to keep that bolt that reminds me of bad news. The upper inside bolt for your J-pipe install, remember the one that first time I ever did it? Well, the first time I tried to use that new bracket, which is actually this one, to be honest, and it stripped out and, like, shouldn't have ever messed with that. This is the new one, not the original one. I put the original one back in because it fits better. Drilling this out and using it is what caused that bolt to strip. So it's, I'm keeping it as a spare if I ever need it. But I'm not using the new bracket that I ordered. I'm using the original one that came with my car. As well as spare genuine Subaru pin clips, I have the universal bag of Amazon ones, about 100 of 2 different kinds of Amazon ones, which are much cheaper, but they do work. They're just not quite as perfect as those Subaru ones. And I have 1 Subaru donut that I've never had to unpack. I've never had a problem with my donut through all those jobs. But I have just a spare one here in case my donut ever gets a crack or anything during a job. That's a good thing to have on hand. And a couple 3-inch, maybe that might be a 2.5. Couple gaskets there. You never know when you'll need one of those for one of your pipe jobs. Keep those handy. 4 really cherry stainless steel sheet metal bolts. So screws. I like to keep these handy for, like, my license plate front and back mounts when I get my new cars, and I just like 4 perfectly matching screws. These are stainless steel, super high quality. See, these are kind of my special screws. I don't throw those in my big lumped up box over there. I keep these special just for special occasions. Oh my god, I got 2 of these. I seriously did not mean to have 2 of these. I must have, like, bought one, totally forgot about it, and then bought another. This is real important because this is the most common bolt size under for your J-pipe type of stuff, such as the bolt that I stripped. That's why I got this. Remember that one? The bolts that go upward into that bracket, into the engine block. Anyway, I definitely do not need 2 of these. I am just going to look it up and sell it, whatever, I don't know, Craigslist, eBay, whatever it takes. I don't need 2 of these, and I'm sure it's worth at least $20, I don't know. My specialty toolbox, my specialty tool drawer, rather. What are these? Oh, I got some taps, looks like. Some mini Torx screwdrivers. These could even be for an iPhone. Another collection mainly for iPhones and laptops. And iFixit.com, whatever the hell that is. Tiny, tiny little tools. You know, I never use these nut drivers, ever. I wonder, I was going to throw them out, but you never throw out tools. I never used, these are too small for hose clamps, but that's a good idea. Those could work really good for hose clamps. This is called a strut spreader. I can't remember if this is Subaru or VW. I think it's VW, but it could use for anything. It's an oblong shape, and you put it between your strut pincher there, and you twist it with the socket to open your pinch so you can pull your strut out of its housing there. Great caliper tool. This isn't a great one, but it works in a pinch. I barely remember what this is. This is some extractor, really fine thread. Off the top of my head, I do not remember what this tool is for. Someone will tell me. Rivet gun, of course. This is a special door tool. This is for VW door hinges and all that. And you stick your little custom Allens, which are somewhere in here, through this, and it's for very tight access in your hinges for the VW doors. Sealed puller, of course, the inner and outer snap ring collection there. Tap and die tools. This is probably the one I did to fix some of my issues. This is probably a 10-125, just like the other one you saw. Custom size socket for something. I bought it for a reason. 17 millimeter internal instead of external socket. I don't remember what this is for. It's for some kind of tranny plug, maybe, something like that. Nothing else here. Got my, you always need the triple square sets, especially for VWs, but maybe for some other stuff. The triple square definitely comes in handy all the time. So I rarely use that, but it is nice to have. And then the ZXN is probably the same thing. Those are some more, I believe, triple squares. Yeah, I got a lot of triple square collection just for emergencies. The Mac tools I got in 1989, probably. I got these wrenches. They're still killer. 1989, I don't know, you count the years. Mac tools, just like Snap-on, last forever. I always preferred Mac to Snap-on, just a personal preference. All my extra wrenches that are not part of my regular nice setup, I buy a lot of these as spares, because a lot of 7/16ths, 14s, a lot of ratcheting wrenches, because a lot of times it'll be the same size wrench on both sides, and as you saw, I only have one of each in the drawer above, so I get an extra 12s, extra 14s, that kind of thing. And of course some of your flare wrenches for brake stuff. Just my weird mixed wrench thing for just when I need a spare wrench. Pliers collection. I rarely use most of these. You know, I have, you know, you always have your go-to favorites. Like I probably have 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 of this type of plier. I just use whichever one that I find. Tons of needle nose types, way more than I need. These ones are rusty. This one must be a cheaper brand. China. Pittsburgh. But still, oh my god, I can't even open it. Still, I don't throw away tools unless they get really bad. Because you can always use tools. Everybody can. I hate this drawer. It's a big mess. Staple gun, strut compressor, spring compressors, hacksaws, battery carrier, which I don't need to have. That's just dumb. Puller, various stuff, even though I don't have a good puller collection, but that's just a few of them. Tons of C-clamps. And there's that really nice Dremel kit I bought once. I think it was $100, maybe. Maybe more than that. I did that just to get my Mishimoto downpipe off. I went out and bought this for that job. And I don't even know if I'll ever use it again. It is good to have, but then again, it's money just sitting there kind of wasting away. I don't know about that one.